Hello, okay. Hello everyone, good evening. So my name is Jaskaran and I'm one of satellite engineer at Radar. Today, my topic is securing infrastructure with OpenScap, the automation way, because it's an era of automation, right? We are, you know, far behind with manual tasks and doing all those things. So automation in terms of working with, So let's start this. My major agenda is to cover what's OpenScap, why do we need it, right? Components, something around it, an integration with Foreman. A lot of you might have heard about Foreman in just last 15 minutes. So I'll give a more idea on that and how it actually works. So in between the talk, I'll have a demo as well. The first question comes to my mind is, of whosoever listens to this, is what is OpenScap, right? It's an open source security scanning tool, which is used for two primary purposes. That is to mitigate software vulnerabilities, to check configurational flaws, to check security flaws, right? So these are the two things that the OpenScap directly focuses on. Whatever software we have in our infrastructure, we have to figure out what flaws are in it, or configurational things that normal day-to-day sysadmins or someone who manages the infrastructure make mistakes. Why do we need OpenScap? It's a way to express security policies in a user interactive format. A lot of people come across and says, there is a vulnerability in a system, but I don't know what it is. What is Meltdown? What is Spectre? A lot of vulnerabilities are out there, but I don't know what to do with it. It's in my infrastructure, right? OpenScap gives you a clear idea what a vulnerability is all about. What to do about it? How to mitigate all those things? OpenScap, SCAP, generally known as, is an NIST standard, certified standard. And there's a lot of security policies. So take that word, security policies. I'll be explaining more about security policies in my later slide. A tool to verify system or infrastructure to make up a certain standards. Now standard comes to my mind. There are a lot of organizations which tends to have a set of standards in their organization. Let's say, talking about XYZ organization. Whenever they give a laptop to a new employee, they want a particular set of operating system to be installed and not any other operating system, right? That's a standard for them. Or for an organization, SSH access to certain systems is disabled. That's a standard, that's a security standard, that's required, right? To maintain those standards, make it more easy for the people who work over there, because just maintaining up the standard is not your work. There's something else you need to do, right? You have your own time to work on different things, not just to maintain up the standards. So OpenScap helps you on that front. From the time the system has been provisioned, or it's into your organization, it's into your infrastructure, OpenScap takes control of that. Modification can be done using tailoring files. Obviously, it's an open source. You can do all your modifications that you want to do. Whatsoever you want to do it, you can do it. And you can make it across all of your infrastructure. It's supported cross-platform, may it be Windows, may it be Linux, anything you want to do it, anything, whatever your infrastructure is consist of, OpenScap supports that. So that's a good point where, a lot of organizations say, okay, this particular open source tool is something for Linux, we can't use it. No, it's for Windows as well. All the standards, all the security profiles, all those things are for Windows as well. There are a few couple of tools which OpenScap gives you. That's first one is Anaconda. A lot of people have heard about Anaconda. That's an installer for a Linux, right? Linux-based system, that's an installer. So in Anaconda, there's a plugin for OpenScap. The time you are building up a system, let's say you are building your own desktop system, one system, Anaconda is out there. Or if you are building a number of systems, yes, you can have your own set of Anaconda file where you can mention out those profiles. You can mention out those rules that you need to check, mention out those standards which you want to, put it in the system that you are building up. SCAP Workbench. This is an GUI tool which SCAP gives you. So, you know, people not comfortable with command line, you can use this tool. It's an absolutely brilliant tool because it gives you, it gives the user an approach for, you know, tailoring out things. You know, modification can be done even if the person is not core technical or he or she doesn't know that if I, you know, omit out this particular rule or omit out this particular standard, what impact it will create, right? What at the background the system is going to happen, even if it doesn't know, OpenScap will take care of that. I mean, the workbench takes care of that. OpenScap daemon, again, the system has been, I mean, the service will be running up in your systems, in your containers, in your infrastructure at the background. And at the time when it feels or you want to configure according to it, you know, every Monday at 6 p.m., the scan needs to be run up. That's one thing. Or at a regular intervals, it needs to be run up. It's, again, taken care of. A lot of people has this idea that, you know what, whatever scan we did in last 6 months, it should be stored just for verification, just for analyzing how we are moving towards security, right? In that case, SCAP taxonomy is a very useful tool for you. You can use your SQL search query, and you can get whatever things, whatever scan reports of just one system, or scan reports of your entire system or entire infrastructure will be out there, and you can, you know, search what all things I can do with that. OpenScap base is just a command line tool, which I'll be showing you up. OpenScap components, okay. So languages is something which, I mean, OpenScap is written in XML. So if you want to write up a rule, you have to know what is XML. XCCDF is a sort of language where it's a kind of a wrapper over OWL rule. So you write a rule in OWL, and over that, there is a wrapper. You know, a lot of people who are from programming background, you must be knowing it. What is a wrapper of, you know, in a programming? So XCCDF is a wrapper, and with the help of these two things, XCCDF and OWL, it creates a data stream file, which is the file which OpenScap used to scan your systems. That's again a rule list. Let's say in OWL, you have a lot of rules written in it. I need SSH access to be disabled. You know, it should be installed on your system. A lot of other things you mention in the form of rules, or it's in the upstream. That has been again collaborated with XCCDF, and you get a data stream file. That particular file is used for scanning up your system. ARF report, this is a sort of a report, a format of a report in which the OpenScap gives you the result. The first result comes up. Also, you can have your results in HTML format, in a beautiful format. You know, you can open up in your browsers and you can give it to people who just want to know what all things or how many systems are being scanned up, or how or if a system is scanned, to what level of, you know, vulnerable. OpenScap components, CVSS, all these things OpenScap looks from NIST. So whatever NIST has its own standard indexing of each and every vulnerability, OpenScap copies that and has its source as it indexed. It's all about OpenScap, but how does it work? Okay, it's a beautiful diagram out here, and which says there are few profiles which I have written over here. PCI DSS profile, it's a profile which has been used by payment gateways. A lot of companies which are using payment gateways, the particular profile has been used by them. Standard Docker, if you are using Docker in your infrastructure, you can use this profile. Standard system profile, that's normal system profile. Maybe you are using CentOS, Ubuntu, Debian, maybe Red Hat, Fedora, something, anything, right? Or maybe Microsoft, Windows, right? That's a standard system profile in which all the rules have been mentioned based on your infrastructure, right? These collaborative profiles are known as SCAP profiles, and it's distributed among the operating system, whatever operating system you use. Collection of these profiles is known as SCAP content. That's all content. Now, the SCAP content can be directly applied to your client systems with the help of OpenScap. That's one thing. But now, this particular project is an open source project. It should have an ability to communicate or to get integrated with other open source projects as well. So here, Foreman comes into the picture, so that diagram with a helmet is Foreman. So with the help of Foreman, you can either use Puppet, whatever Puppet you want to use. You want to use Puppet Enterprise, right? Or you want to go with Ansible, you want to go with Chef, Salt, anything can be used with Foreman, and you can then apply it on your client systems. Sorted. If it's, I mean, you are using Foreman in your infrastructure, by Foreman, nothing in your infrastructure, just direct systems, do it with OpenScap. I was talking about profiles. So this is just an image which gives you an idea that what all sort of profiles, I was talking about. That is health insurance portability, maybe something related to hospitals. PCID, I've already talked about. Red Hat corporate profile. Again, this is a company-specific profile, right? If you have a systems on that. C2S for Red Hat, you know, cloud-based instances. A lot of other profiles which we can scroll down and we can have those profiles mentioned over there. There's also an option of tailoring files. Let's say based on these profiles, C2S profile for Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7 is a very strict for your infrastructure. Let's move out some, you know, cross out some rules, and that particular file, I mean, you have to generate a new file, and that particular file can be known as tailoring file. So based on one standard profile, you have your own custom tailoring profile which have an addition of rules or some rules which you have striked off. So this is a report of how OpenScap report comes up. So there's an evaluation target. I have mitigated it. It will give you our, you know, host by system. When the scan happened, when it got finished, by which user, even if you are using AD or, you know, LDAP or something, it will give you the user which user scanned this result. What, how many rules got passed, which were failed, and which were not even checked, right? Checked as in, you want a particular rule not to be checked in your system because that is something your organization wants. So you can, you know, skip that rule. This is the rules which you have in your system, whichever are failed, whichever are passed, somewhere are not checked. The beautiful thing is you can just click on that rule and it will give you the description about it, what that particular rule was, and what all things you need to do about it to mitigate that particular thing or to pass that result, right? With OpenScap, you get also a flexibility to do all the stuff with Bash, with Ansible playbook, or with Puppet modules. So this is how you just click on Ansible scriptlet and it gives you the Ansible playbook. But this is for each and every rule which got failed. But you want to mitigate all the rules. You just have to click a command. Okay, I'll give you the command now. And the Ansible playbook will be generated for all those rules which are failed. Okay. So this is the command. And it will generate the Ansible playbook. We have the Ansible playbook over here. Simple. How does it looks like? I'll give you that also. How that my Ansible playbook looks like. Something like this. It got generated with this particular command. It was for this system. All the inventories and everything are out here for all those rules which were failed. Right. Now, this is the command that I have used. Now, OpenScap get also integrated with a lot of other enterprise products or open source products as well. So let's say you want to use on a very small infrastructure, you can use Daemon or Workbench because it's easy to manage. Or if you want to use on a large systems, you can definitely use Foreman, SUSE Manager, Red Hat Cloud Forms, Satellite 5, Satellite 6, anything you want to use. You can integrate with, let's say, I mean, I'm giving an example with Foreman because it's open source, right? What Foreman does is it gives you a platform to manage your infrastructure. Let's say you have VMs, you have containers, what all things you have in your infrastructure. It gives you all the help to manage out your infrastructure. It gives you, it has three major features. That is provisioning of a system, configuration, monitoring, because once you provision it, you need some sort of configuration on the in your infrastructure. And then once everything is set up, monitoring is done. So Foreman is quite integratable with lot of other components, EC2, Google Cloud, OWERD, OpenStack. What all things you want to use, you can use it, and you can manage all your systems which are deployed over there. You can manage over here as well. provisioning, you can provision, I mean, once you set up Foreman, you can provision any system on any sort of platform which you have. You have platform, you are using DigitalOcean, maybe OWERT, VMware, Docker, anything, you know, any platform you're using. It's very easily integratable, and you can deploy all the systems on the platform that you are using. Configuration, majorly it's Puppet and Ansible. Previously it was using with Puppet, and now it's been using Ansible. But let's say you don't want to use this, you want to go some with something else. Chef, Salt, anything else can be used. Right, okay. Monitoring, this is one thing which needs to be done. There are a lot of APIs which are well documented. The documentation is fabulous and gives you proper API monitoring, gives you the OpenScap report generation. You can generate that report and you can get it on a web UI. A single dashboard, you can get all the reports of entire infrastructure. Now, you have a lot of systems and you don't know which particular system lies in which organization or which place, which data center. You can directly search it through SQL query or directly with hostname. And it works, you know, across the application in whatever page you are, it will search it and it will give it to you. This is how something your OpenScap database, Foreman database, dashboard looks like. It gives you what all things, like the overview, what all systems are being scanned, what all systems are synced, you know, updated. All the things will be, you know, in the dashboard. And this particular image is of a system which has been provisioned with the help of Foreman. So all the IPs, all the system facts will be out there for each and every system. Whatever configuration you want to do, it will be out there. Even before deploying the system, once it's deployed and comes to your hand, you can do other configuration things. Let's say, you know what, provision the system, make this sort of configuration, and once this configuration is done, when the system is built, you know, scan with this OpenScap. Everything is sorted. You have all the automation done at your end, and it's good to go. Anyways, okay, so, okay. All right, so like every other product, OpenScap also has a limitation. You know, if you want to make a new rule, you know, a lot of people comes to, you know, say, and you know what, we have our own auditing system, we have our own auditors, which they have their own scripts, and they come and they check our organization, and they audit the organization. So what if we want to write our own rules? I would say it's not that easy to write your own rules. You just need to know XML, and then a proper wrapper should be out there, and you can build your own rule. But yeah, by default, whatever rules are out there, you have to use that. Only takes vulnerability in vendor's package, not in EPL as of now. There are future plans of OpenScap to, you know, have EPL into place, but you know, I'm not pretty sure how far it's been going on. Not in third-party vendors, like, you know, software that you develop, you know, let's say you develop for some RPM or some other you know, software package you develop, OpenScap won't be able to help on that front, right? Detects only vulnerability important enough to fix RSAs, so it's more of, you know, company driven where your security advisories are being concerned. Security policies don't get updated automatically under Foreman. So in whichever open source or enterprise level, you know, project you integrate OpenScap, it has a drawback that the profile that I was talking about in the diagram, the Docker profile, the standard profile, doesn't get updated automatically. We need to have some sort of automation done at that end so that, you know, from repository, those profiles get updated. And once those are updated, again, things will be sorted at your end, right? So it was all in a nutshell that how an open source tool is easy to use at your end, right? Just for one, two systems or for your entire infrastructure, whether it's, you know, it is on any of the platforms. So I guess that is all. I'm running out of my time, I guess. So it's fine, it's good. Okay, any questions anyone have around this, around Foreman, around OpenScap, anything you can, you know, guys, you can shoot me out.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Prerna. So basically, I have a question regarding this OpenScap. So there is an infrastructure tool, NESIS.
Right.
Yeah. So what's the difference between these two? I mean, so OpenScap is just for only, like you mentioned, NIST-based framework as well as PCI DSS. So for those policies,
right,
it will scan for a whole infrastructure also, like NESIS, in NESIS scans we use.
Yes, NESIS scans will be, I mean, you can integrate OpenScap profiles in your NESIS scan. Let's say you have already paid for it. It's a paid product, I believe, right? You have already paid for it. So you can, you know, you can pull out those profiles which OpenScap gives you, and you can integrate it within your NESIS tool.
Okay.
Right, so you have, do not have to, again, redeploy OpenScap, but it's just like, it's an add-on security which gives you a, you know, advantage of, you know, covering a larger database of security policies.
Okay. So it's specific to the standards like PCI DSS and NIST-based frameworks. It's specific to that only, or it will scan for a whole infrastructure also?
It will scan the entire infrastructure. Okay. So it will scan the networking part, whatever networking part you have in your infrastructure, and as well as the standardizations that you want to maintain.
Okay.
Right? So anytime you can, you know, tailor out those things in the rule list. So I can show you the rule, how rules are being done. So these are the rules that we have, and anytime you want to customize it, you can directly go and you can just click it, or let's say I want to have this rule. Just click it and make a customization file. This is a tailoring file you have. And now you can integrate it with your NESIS tool, or if you want to use it with OpenScap, you can use it directly with OpenScap.
Okay. Thank you.
Right.
Okay. Hi, Nemo here.
Yeah.
I had a question around the Red Hat side of things. So since you mentioned it only supports RHSAs,
right,
and the policies that you're showing also are very RPM specific.
Right.
How well does it work with non-Red Hat distributions?
It works with non-Red Hat distributions, absolutely fine. It works with Ubuntu, because, okay, I'll show you the Ubuntu part. So as of now, I can load any sort of, you know, operating system you have, and these are the profiles which will be, you know, in your system, and you can, you know, use anything. It can be Debian, it can be Ubuntu, it can be even Windows. I don't have a Windows right now, but it can be anything. So it doesn't restrict you to Red Hat. Red Hat is a part, but, you know, you can go around with any of the other operating systems.
Yeah, I have two questions. First one is, what are the reasons that they chose XML as a formatting thing? And secondly, how hard is it to write some JSON or YAML, you know, formatter that OpenScap can take as input?
I would say this is all, I mean, I'm not pretty sure why they have chosen XML as a part. They could have chosen other you know, languages, you know, to work, but I'm not pretty sure on this front. And I'm since I'm not a maintainer, I'm not, you know, the correct person for that. But for, in terms of the next part was YAML, right? So it all depends on the person who is using it. So for me, if I'm using OpenScap, for me it's not very difficult to write an XML or a YAML, right? But for the person, let's say, who is on a position as known as manager, he just want to know what all things are there, but he still wants to, you know, have a tech background, or you want to still touch base on, you still have to check what all things are going on in this system. This particular tool gives you proper insight, what, with host, which rule, why, how to mitigate it, and it also gives you the, you know, flexibility with Ansible, if he knows or he or she knows it, you know, Ansible Puppet or anything, you know, he can mitigate it, the description of about it. So all the things are, you know, done for the person who is not even very good in terms of technicalities, but yes, he still want to go ahead with it. Yeah.
Does it has the capability to scan Docker images?
Yes, it has. There is an atomic scan which can be run on Dockers.
Okay. So
I have not shown over here, but yes, OpenScap has the capacity, to scan Docker images and containers.
So it has inbuilt profiles for it?
Pardon?
Inbuilt profiles?
Inbuilt profiles? Yes, we have different profiles as well for that.
Okay. Thank you.
Hi, I have one question on web scanning part.
I can't see. Okay. Yeah.
So as Nessus scanner or OpenVAS, we do have a ability to scan web-based URL as well as the system profiles. So if I'm running an OpenVAS, do you recommend to go for this SCAP?
It all depends on you and your infrastructure, right? Let's say you are pretty much comfortable with OpenVAS. You can go ahead with that, not a problem. But if you still want to give a try to OpenScap, definitely you should give, because there could be certain changes or a different approach towards scanning up your same infrastructure. So I would say definitely give a try. But if you still don't want, again, it's an open source world, you know, you can walk off.
I have actually two questions. One, does it scan the container itself, or it scans the image?
No, it scans the container as well.
Okay. And second one is, how do you make sure that the code that your tool has generated is compatible with the version of Ansible or Puppet or Chef you are using?
The second question, I'm not clear. Can you just repeat it?
So there might be, you know, compatibility metrics in between the configuration management tool and OpenScap.
Okay.
So how you're making sure that they both are compatible.
Right. So behind this, whatever rule, let's say you write today, you have to give Ansible playbook or a Puppet playbook, whatever feasible to you, whatever feasible to the developer or the person who is writing a rule, and give it in the upstream. Right. So they upstream gets checked which rule or which Ansible playbook runs on which systems. Let's say that's one thing for your configurational tool. OpenScap needs to manage by Ansible 2.7, right? So both, it's again at the end, Ansible playbook will be running up. And the rule, the task in the Ansible playbook will be the one of your own system, not for Puppet or not for Ansible, or core Puppet. The rule, the task will be for the system or the infrastructure that you have, the configuration that you have done. It won't change the Puppet configurations, it won't change the Ansible configurations, but it will change the system configurations. So let's say you have, in login.tf, some rule you have written, or in profiles, you have mentioned some sort of things, right? Once you log in into Bash, you have some things in your terminal. It won't change that, but it will give you a hint that, you know what, you have to, this is something which is deprecated, or this is something which is not secure enough for your infrastructure. So now you can use it with a Bash script or Ansible playbook. So it will change that configuration. So custom scans, custom things, custom configurations will be something which will be a human invention. It needs to take place. But if this is something related to more of a package, OpenScap will take place of that. So I'm not pretty sure whether I have answered your question. But yeah, we can discuss that offline. Anyone else? All right.
Okay. Thank you, Jaskaran. So.